Good morning to all of you. Today we will learn Khagam from English 2. Here, the story in our book is adapted from a short story by the same name, written by Satyajit Ray. Satyajit Ray was an Indian film director, scriptwriter, documentary filmmaker, author, lyricist, magazine editor, illustrator, calligrapher, and music composer. He is widely considered to have been one of the greatest filmmakers of all time, celebrated for works such as the Apu Trilogy, The Music Room, The Big City, and Charulata. Ray was born in Calcutta into a Bengali caste family which was prominent in the field of arts and literature. Starting his career as a commercial artist, he was drawn into independent filmmaking after meeting French filmmaker Jean Renoir and viewing Vittorio De Sica's Italian neorealist film Bicycle Thieves during a visit to London. In Khagam by Satyajit Ray, we have the theme of tradition, modernity, kindness, trust, curiosity, control, change, arrogance, and power. Taken from his The Collected Short Stories collection, the story is narrated in the first person by an unnamed male narrator, and after reading the story, the reader realizes that Ray may be exploring the theme of tradition. Babu has no time for Imli Baba or the traditions that he believes in. He much prefers to see scientific evidence when it comes to matters that require an explanation. This may be significant as in many ways Ray is pitting tradition against modernity. With Baba as a holy man, being a practitioner of tradition, while Babu is the opposite and believes that modernity will give an explanation for everything. It might also be important that the narrator sticks by Babu, even though he only knows him for 2 days, as this would suggest that the narrator is a good-willed and kind man. Throughout the story, he is prepared to help Babu, even though he does not have any expected allegiance to him. It is also possible that Ray is exploring the theme of change, with it being clear to the reader that Babu has been transformed by Baba's curse into a snake. What is also interesting about the story is how strongly Babu disagrees with Baba. The reader is aware that Babu has previously had a negative experience when it came to a holy man, and as such no longer trusts holy men. This could be important as Babu is allowing one incident or misfortunate incident with a holy man cloud his judgment when it comes to all holy men. When the reality is that it was Babu's uncle who sent him to a holy man rather than to a doctor. If anything, Babu's uncle is to blame for what happened to Babu when he was younger. It is also interesting that the narrator suggests that Babu should see a doctor, as this could suggest that the narrator, like Babu, believes in modern medical practices over the traditional role played by holy men. However, the narrator's curiosity is so strong, he still nonetheless wishes to see Baba. The fact that Babu kills Balkishan is also interesting, as it is as though he is bitter towards Baba and is unable to let go of his previous experiences with holy men. If anything, Babu may wish to take control away from Baba, and the notion that he has the ability to tame a king cobra snake. If anything, it may be a case that Ray is suggesting that by killing Balkishan, Babu feels as though there is a battle of wills occurring between him and Baba. A battle that Babu eventually loses due to some critics might suggest is his ignorance when it comes to powers and abilities of holy men. The end of the story is also interesting as the reader realizes just how powerful Baba actually is. It is also noticeable that Baba is remarkably calm when he tells the narrator where Babu is. Nothing seems to faze Baba. He sits calmly at his hut as if nothing unusual has happened, and in many ways nothing unusual has happened for those who believe in the abilities of a holy man. A lesson that Babu might have been best served to have learnt before he arrogantly killed Balkishan. If anything, Babu has paid for his arrogance with his life. Where once he took the form of a human being, he is now a king cobra snake. This is somewhat ironic for a man who did not believe in the abilities of holy men. Any doubt that the narrator may have about Baba's abilities are also dispelled when he sees Babu's skin hanging from a tree. If anything, Ray may be suggesting that when it comes to holy men or tradition, one is better off being open-minded. Something that would have saved Babu's life if he had not been blinded by his own arrogance. Babu paid the ultimate price for not believing in Baba's powers.